I think it had everything to do with, with television, in fact. It had everything to do with the immediacy with which you saw when you went home after your classes on television, in color, children being machine gunned, or huge billowing flames coming out of some village, and peasants running out of the village and dying in the process. That had never, it was totally different in that way from anything else. And I think it actually, but people might disagree with me, I think it had not that much to do with communism, with very large ideological, complicated configurations of thinking. It was an immediate, visceral reaction. This we cannot do. This is unbearable. This is too revolting. And this is something we cannot live with. There was a sense that the napalm wasn't just dropping on them. There was a sense in which our integrity was being napalmed, in which our flesh was burning off because we were sitting still for this. And so people were outraged in a way that was unequaled and unparalleled. From watching the immediacy of what was happening, that some other way, some other way had to be possible to carry this forward. And I think, like in lots of these things, there was the immediate, powerful, absolute reaction, and then one studied, and then one learned, and then one put a lot of things into place. And it really did seem as if, a lot of stuff that was being said, for example, that this had to be a way of somehow protecting us against China was absurd, because in fact the Vietnamese, anybody who wanted to know could find out that the Chinese and the Vietnamese were hostile to each other.